Concert goers who escaped this madness described the unrelenting, unending sound of the gunfire, and initially having no idea what it was and no idea where it was coming from. And that includes my next guest, Alexandra Jones. She and her friends were standing right next to the stage when they realized they were in danger. Alexandra, thank you so much for being here. And so crazy, traumatic to go through. You were, I'm sure, very shaken up by this.
Definitely.
How are you feeling? How are you feeling? How are your friends?
We're all a little shaken, obviously. It's been a crazy few hours, 12, actually. And right now we're all at home, obviously. My friends are with their families. It's sort of surreal right now to think what happened. It hasn't hit me yet. I think in the next few days it will, absolutely.
You were just to the left of the stage enjoying Jason Aldean, and then when did you realize what actually was happening?
It was probably when the music cut off. What I heard at first was, to me, sounded, it could have been fireworks. I was thinking, oh, maybe a helicopter is coming overhead, which it had been the entire weekend. And as soon as I saw the music stop and heard the music stop, and then people started running, was when the light bulb clicked on and we realized we need to get out of here. And one of my other friends, she told us to run. I grabbed the other one by her hand and we bolted to the side of the venue and ran out the gates, jumped over fences. Everyone was just in a panic. And it's not lost on me that we were one of the lucky ones, because we were on the edge of the large group of people that were there, the 20,000 people that were there last night.
I keep hearing from people like you saying, well, they ran with crowds. You know, when the crowd got up, everyone got up, or when the crowd raced out, everyone raced out. They were afraid to be alone and in view of the shooter.
Yeah, and it was even more terrifying not knowing exactly where the shooter was. My first impression was he was in the crowd, or she at the time. I really thought he was in the crowd. It wasn't until after we were safe in a hotel watching the news that we realized he was in Mandalay Bay.
How did you get out then? Who helped you?
It was me and one of my friends were running, and we kind of got separated from our other two friends, and just good Samaritans along the way. We had one gentleman who said, hey, come here, let me help you over this fence, because everything was locked. We couldn't get to the hotel property straight away. So this guy helped us over a fence, and we just kept running. Two amazing people, this wonderful couple, Alexis and Michael, I don't know where you are, but thank you so much. They ran with us into Hooters Hotel, and we just tried to calm ourselves down, make our phone calls, and we all huddled in our hotel room for hours until we could figure out what was going on. But it was just the kindness of everyone who was there that helped us get away from the madness and helped us find our other friends.
I'm sure, was the first phone call to your family? Can you just tell me about that phone call and what you said?
It was, my first phone call was to my dad. I was definitely crying. And it was a phone call I never imagined I would ever make. But because the service was in and out, he didn't really understand what I was saying. He's saying, what happened? Because probably about 20 minutes before, I called him freaking out that I lost my ID. And he's thinking, oh, maybe she's, you know, still freaking out about this. But when he realized what was going on, he was like, okay, do you want us to come get you? And him and my mom drove up last night about 12 o'clock, 11 o'clock, and picked us up about 4 a.m. And we got home a couple hours ago.
What a difference 20 minutes can make. And I'm so glad you're okay. Alexandra Jones, thank you so much for the time. I know your family is happy to have you back. Thank you. I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
We